let's look back on this year 2020. Perhaps the shittiest year that we have ever had. Well, ups and downs, we know there have been plenty.
I think when this year's fucked off,
we will all be glad. It all looked pretty normal back in January. We saw the new year in singing Auld Lang Syne.
Auld Lang Syne.
We were laughing, joking, dancing, we were merry. Who would have thought in 6 months this would be a crime? But as the weeks and days and hours and minutes went past, we got a hint that things were not quite going to plan. There was this virus spreading quicker than a sandblast. It was scarier than the bogeyman. At times it's been frustrating, at times it has been dull, sometimes dangerous. My black bin, it has never been so full. When the sun was shining, there were elements of bliss. Pat Lucas and John Bishop hilariously taking the piss. 2020 has been crazy, 2020 has been weird. I think we'll feel much better when this year has disappeared. 2020's been like Christmas when you get a lump of coal. 2020, you can kiss my bottom hole. In March, well, things were looking bleaker. It was spreading like a fart under a duvet. And you could only see your family from 2 meters. And your kids were not allowed to go and play. How can we possibly not mention panic buying?
Selfish dickheads!
Fill their freezers up with bread. No bog roll left several people crying. They had to wash their arse in the sink instead. We spent our days buying random shit from B&Q and Wicks. Now all the furniture and barbecues were gone. I wish that I had bought 1,000 shares in Netflix instead of blowing all my cash on Amazon. We've seen Ant and Dec stood on their own presenting BGT, but at least we've had Afterlife too.
Nice one, Ricky.
Every kitchen diner has become a new classroom. Then trying to have a party, getting pissed with your mates over Zoom. 2020 has been crazy, 2020 has been odd. It's been a bit like losing all your stuff, then getting robbed. 2020's been like trying to wipe your arse with no bog roll. 2020, you could kiss my bottom hole. Now you get kicked out at 10 on a pub crawl.
Let's not forget
the government's rule of six, but they can still hug and kiss when they play football. Sometimes I think that they're taking the piss. Just as we thought we were kicking out this virus, rules and regulations became more relaxed. Some of me mates on Facebook, they fucked off to Cyprus on a plane with 100 other people wearing a shitty little mask. Don't get me wrong, I'm not one to judge, but I can't go and visit my old gram. And though I try my best not to hold a grudge,
I'd feel better if some twat had a plan.
We've had Mr. Dominic Cummings, who didn't see the light. He drove 260 miles to test out his eyesight. We've queued up outside the supermarkets in the pissing rain. Musicians have been told they should now retrain. But there's been a nice togetherness of our communities, helping out the vulnerable. It's been so nice to see. We've seen many massive companies treat their staff with respect,
but there's always one in the boat.
That's right from Sports Direct.
2020 has given us some lessons. It's made us laugh, it's made us cry, it's made us scream. And in our minds we've asked ourselves many questions.
But on the plus side, my hands are squeaky clean.
We stood on our doorsteps and we've clapped and cheered our NHS. We've seen fireworks and balloons in the skies. For the work that they have done, as a nation we are blessed. But it seems it's our MPs that need a rise.
Fucking hell.
2020 has been crazy, 2020 has been weird. I think we'll feel much better when this year has disappeared. 2020's getting boring, 2020's getting old. 2020, you can kiss my bottom hole.